Let's talk integrity. So we talk a lot about integrity means doing what you said you were going to do, doing it on time, being integrity with who you are as you present yourself to be online. But let's talk a moment about what happens when you break your integrity, because we're not always all perfect all the time. Sometimes you say you're going to do something and you don't do it. Sometimes something gets in the way. Maybe it's something with you that you're procrastinating on something. Maybe it's something outside of your control that happens in your life. You have an unexpected emergency that comes up. So from time to time, even those of us who value integrity, who have, who live by integrity and who only operate with around people who also value integrity, even those of us, we mess up from time to time. So what is it that you should do when you accidentally make a mistake, you miss a deadline, or you say or do something that isn't in integrity with who you say you are? Well, the good news is there are steps to restore integrity, and all we have to do is take through these few steps to restore integrity, and then you'll be back to 100% integrity. What happens if you don't restore integrity is that now you're at, say, 98% integrity because you got 2 points off for the little deadline that you missed. If you never restore back to 100, then the next time you miss a deadline or the next time you fudge up and mess up, you're continuing to diminish your integrity points. So restoring integrity is a super big important part of integrity that we don't talk about very much. So what are these steps to restore integrity? Let's talk about them right now. The first step to restoring integrity is to, aha, ta-da, acknowledge that you have broken your promise. Acknowledge that you missed your deadline. Acknowledge that you said something stupid that you didn't mean. And apologize to the person, the persons, the group, whoever it is that you made that promise to. So just like the 12 steps for Alcoholics Anonymous or for any of the sobriety type programs, the first step is just to actually acknowledge that you broke your promise. The second step is to actually take responsibility for it, even when it's something out of your control. Even if you are late to a meeting because the airline canceled your flight, it's still not the fault or the responsibility of the people that you were supposed to meet with. Therefore, it's your responsibility. So you always take responsibility for, I was late, I missed my meeting. Yes, it was because of the airline, but ultimately it was my job to be here on time. I could have taken an earlier flight. Maybe I should have flown the day before. There's millions of things that you could have done differently. Refer back to my 5 steps for business breakup to talk about. Don't get stuck in the woulda, shoulda, couldas, but obviously you can take responsibility for your part in having not made it to the meeting on time. The second, apologizing and taking responsibility and apologizing to the people that were impacted by your having missed your promise. Then the third step is to actually check in over there with them. I mentioned there's an impact on them. So you have to actually be concerned or have an interest in that impact and what happened because you were late, because you missed the deadline, because you missed the meeting, because you spoke out of integrity. What's the impact on the other person? Now, sometimes there's no impact because you have a great relationship with the person. It's no big deal. You'll just catch up. But if you don't ever ask, then you don't really know. Sometimes it really impacts the situation of a group effort that you were late. Now everyone has to reschedule. Or maybe the impact is because you were late to the meeting or because you weren't there, you didn't get to contribute. Therefore, the outcome of the meeting is diminished. It's not the same. And you have to be willing and be vulnerable to hear the answer that they give you. And no matter what the answer they give you, you really have to just get that that's their experience of what it was like for you to have broken your promise. This is the time when we all want to defend and deflect and point to the blame game, right? About it wasn't my fault. It was my, it's Southwest, it's American Airlines, it's whoever, it's their fault. But the truth is that it's your job, not Southwest's or American Airlines, to get you to places on time. There's a traffic jam, none of that. The point is that no matter whose fault it was, you really have to be able to take responsibility and then figure out what it is that you can do to restore integrity. Now, you may have some suggestions about what you think you can do to restore integrity, but the real person or persons that get to say what it means to restore integrity are the people who were impacted. So let me tell you a little story about this. About 10 years ago, I was the community manager for an online community, and the person that I was managing, who was my admin, was constantly not turning in their statistics on time. So every week on Friday by 10 a.m., their statistics were due to me, and they would never turn their statistics on time. And so as a manager, maybe you start by saying, hey, where's your statistics? Or, hey, it's 10 a.m., I'm looking for your statistics. And you might try other strategies to try to get this person to turn in their statistics on time. But eventually, at some point over time of consistently not doing it on time, I now start to not believe this person anytime they give me their word that they're going to do anything, not just their statistics. Well, now I relate to this person as somebody who never turns things in on time and can't be trusted to do anything that they say they're going to do. So what happens in this case is it's not that person to say, I promise I'm going to get them to you on time. From now on in the future, I'm always going to get you stuff on time. And if something happens, I'll let you know. And, saying all of those things sounds great, but it didn't solve the problem for me. It didn't actually restore the integrity back to 100%. So once my admin finally used these steps to restore integrity and asked me what it would take to restore integrity with me, the answer was, I would need you to turn in your statistics on time every week for the next 2 to 3 months. And at that point, I would now believe that you're a person that can keep their word. Now, why is that the case? Well, anybody can turn something around and keep their word for a short window of time, but it was the consistency and the dedication of over time showing up that would actually have me now trust this person again and restore the integrity. Now, this is true not just in your business and your working relationships. This is true in your personal life as well. If somebody breaks a promise to you and they do it consistently, or even if they do it one time and it has an impact on you, then you need to have a conversation with the person. Or again, if you are the person, to acknowledge that you broke your promise, apologize for the broken promise, and really mean it. Don't do that BS, I'm sorry I hurt your feelings. That's don't do that. You actually really need to understand that somebody's feelings were hurt or somebody else's work was impacted and really actually apologize for having impacted them. Then get interested and curious about what it would take to actually restore integrity for that person. The last and final step, as you guys know, is to do the work to restore the integrity and to keep in communication about it until those 2 to 3 months pass, at which time or whatever the agreement is that you make with that person to restore the integrity. And once it is actually restored, you can declare it complete and move on. Now you have a clean slate with that person and you can start all over again freshly, not having that nagging thought in the back of your mind that this is a person who doesn't keep their word. Those are my steps to restore integrity. I hope you liked this video. If you want to see more, subscribe to the channel. You can also follow me on Instagram or TikTok. Of course, I'm Kate Buck Jr. on all the platforms, and I'll see you in the next video.